at night, they used to have wonderful shows, and I can remember going to see Nat King Cole, and evidently this was his last public appearance before he got ill, and afterwards he came down to the Hayes basement and played the piano most of the night, and I sat on the piano stool with him, and I was trying to stump him, and he was laughing, and we just had the best time. It was so wonderful.
Mandy.
Oh, I can see him in front of me right now. And I was only 5 years old. And he just won the Hamiltonian. And my father was with me, had me at Goshen with him. And Jimmy Wingfield was the groom. And I can remember my dad asked Jimmy if I could sit on his back when he was cooling out. And Jimmy said, sure. So put me up, and I walked round and round while Jimmy was cooling out Greyhound. It was just wonderful. I've carried that memory all my life.
Peter Haughton was killed instantly. He was only 25.
And after Peter died, Bill really couldn't go near the horse for a month or so. And I said, Bill, this is foolish. And he started to go to train and to jog Burgermeister. And then he did become obsessed with trying to get this horse to the Hamiltonian.
From that moment on, despite running one of racing's largest stables, only Bill's hands would touch
Burgermeister. Lots of tears. Lots of tears. Happiness, tears, sadness, tears. Very hard. Bill said I wasn't even driving the horse, I was just a passenger.
It was the last Hamiltonian winner that Bill Haughton would drive.